For the last couple of years, Colombia has been one of Latin America's top performing economies, but there's no guarantee that that momentum will continue. Now, because I know the internet loves a good list, here are the top five challenges to Colombia's rise.
Let's face it, Colombian growth has been based to an extent on strong commodity prices, and those prices have been falling in the last year. Colombia is particularly vulnerable to oil prices.
Estábamos acomodados a un precio de $100 por barril. Eso ya no va a ser así. El mundo cambió.
Oil exports count for about a quarter of government financing, and oil prices have dropped in half in the last year. You can do the math at home, but it ain't pretty.
So, how can Colombia diversify? Bogota has bet heavily on trade integration.
From Europe to United States to East Asia, Colombia has aggressively pursued free trade agreements. But just signing a piece of paper isn't going to create growth on the ground.
And even though they've done all these free trade agreements, they hadn't put in place some of the things that the economy needs to take full advantage of it, particularly transport infrastructure.
Indeed, one critical bottleneck is the country's subpar road system.
Colombia is a country that's rich in natural resources, but getting those resources from the countryside to the port can be as expensive as shipping them to Asia.
Luis Fernando Mejia has been tasked with building the country's development plan.
So we are making a two-pronged approach. First, increasing the two-carriage highways, the Doble Calzada, the 4G, which are connecting the big cities with the ports. But also we have a very important program in the current development plan about what we call tertiary roads, which are municipal roads, that these specific roads are connecting small municipalities with these two carriage highways.
The government hopes to implement this $20 billion program in the next 4 years. Until then, we'll wait.
Because the Colombian left has been largely associated with the rebels, it hasn't established itself within legitimate politics. That's a problem in a country where a lot of people are still poor.
The hope is that in a state of peace, Colombia's left can find a constructive voice in the legitimate political sphere. Iván Cepeda is a leading senator from the left.
Nuestra propuesta se basa en los derechos de la gente.
Iván's father was also a senator, and he was assassinated along with thousands of others the last time the left tried to participate in legitimate politics in the 1990s. For peace to work, Colombia must not let that happen again.
Cuando usted tiene una situación de pobreza rural, de exclusión, y a eso se le suma la persecución política, pues va a surgir una situación de violencia. Y eso es lo que hemos tenido 50 años en Colombia. Por eso queremos la paz, como resultado de un diálogo político. Y la idea es garantizarle a la gente su derecho a la salud, su derecho a la vivienda, su derecho a una vida digna.
With global integration comes exposure. For example, cheaper oil and a stronger dollar have led to a depreciated Colombian peso.
So a year ago, this piece of paper was worth about a buck. Now it's worth 66 cents.
Thus far, the depreciation has not generated inflation, but some local businesses fear a knock-on effect.
Todo lo que usted produce en Colombia es susceptible a exportación. Colombia produce una tonelada de mantequilla al día. Entonces usted me dice, amigo, yo quiero ver mantequilla. Y entonces, y él me dice, necesito mantequilla, parce. Entonces yo le digo, Rogelio, la tonelada de mantequilla, huevón, yo la vendo a 10,000. Y entonces usted llega y me dice, yo no te doy 10,000, yo te doy 100,000. Y te los doy en verdes. Yo te lo vendo a vos, porque es negocio. Entonces, ¿qué pasar con este chiquillo? Este chico pierde su negocio.
The flip side is that a cheaper peso could help Colombia compete. Mariana Sarasti is Colombia's Vice Minister of Trade.
Es una gran oportunidad para que los proveedores nacionales que compiten con importaciones crezcan y provean sus productos a otras empresas colombianas, por un lado. Pero también es una oportunidad para aumentar las exportaciones definitivamente.
Macroeconomics and two-carriage roads are important, no doubt. But we can't avoid the 800-pound guerrilla in the room.
Mucha gente no viene a Colombia simplemente porque es un país que está dentro de la lista de un país con conflicto armado. El turismo se despegaría y este país tiene un enorme potencial por el turismo. La inversión extranjera, estoy seguro que vendría con mucho más entusiasmo al ver que el tema de el conflicto armado y la guerra ha sido resuelto.
If President Santos is right, then the peace process is of paramount importance. So just what is going on in Havana?